Here we are at Superbooth 2018 with Mike from Behringer, and we're going to take a look at the brand new Pro One.
Wow.
So, the Pro One, is it a feature for feature? Is that recreation?
Yes. It's a one-on-one recreation of the sequential PowerKit's Pro One, and it's as close as it can get. Right now, I have to say, it's still a handmade sample. It's not fully feature complete. Mm-hmm. We don't have the sequencer implemented. Some stuff is not working, but we have the basic stuff working, so we can show it a bit and give you a bit idea of how it sounds.
Okay, so the Pro One, the sequential Pro One, when it came out, it's quite a cult synth now, isn't it?
Yes,
it is. What do you think made it special?
It's the sound of the oscillators. The Pro One was of the first one. We used the SEM 3340 oscillator and a 3320 filter. And that makes a big part of the sounds, the way it's implemented. It also has a special modulation
Yes,
that works a bit special, where you have the destinations here, and you can simultaneously modulate them either via LFO, via oscillator, B frequency, or the filter envelope, which is like your modulation throughout. It, of course, got very famous when Vince Clarke used it, obviously, for Don't Go.
Don't Go, yeah.
And
can you play it?
No, I'm not really a player. I'm a guitar player.
So
I've come from the TC guitar team. Ah, so that's my way. But I can work my roundabout synthesizers.
That's cool.
So, let's start maybe. We're hearing... Let's give me a little run-through. Mm-hmm. So we have two oscillators. First oscillator has a saw wave and a square wave variable pulse width. It can also be synced to oscillator 2.
Cool.
On oscillator 2, here you have the octave range switch from the 4 octave. The second oscillator has also a triangle wave. And like with a SEM 3340 chip, you can use them all at the same time. Mm. So it's not either or, you can get them.
And also complex oscillator sound, yeah.
Yes. And oscillator 2 can also work in low frequency mode.
If you want like an LFO.
Like an LFO, exactly. Mm-hmm. So you can either also switch off the keyboard tracking for like FX kind of style. If we look further in the modulation, we have an LFO here with three waveforms that can also work simultaneously to vary the shapes. The final version will also have a working sequencer with two sequences that you can switch. So if we go further back down, we have the mixer, oscillator AB, and you can also send in noise on external signals via the patch points.
And it wasn't patch points on the original, so that's...
That's something we added, the only one. Well, it doesn't affect the sound.
No, no.
But I think
it's a bit more flexibility.
Yes, for the modular crown, if you like the sound.
And also we've got USB on the back there and MIDI. Well, MIDI. Well, the original had MIDI, didn't it?
Yes.
It didn't have MIDI.
So it was first, I think, the Prophet 600 had.
Oh, the Prophet 600, you're right. Yes. You're right, yeah. Do we know when it's going to be shipping?
Well, as it's like a handmade, still early prototype.
Still early days. Okay.
I can say 2018. We hope to get this on, but also with our products in line, it will be rather late this year, realistically.
Has a price point been set?
Yeah, the price point we can already talk, I think, will be the same as the Neutron and Model D. So $299, $349, somewhere between, depending where you buy it, which currency it is.
Okay.
So, but the idea is... It has to be this. It should be the same price.
Wow. Yeah. Okay. So, at this kind of price point, you can really justify having all three, I think.
No, that is mine. If you look here, the pots are not rocky. It's an extremely well-built machine.
Mm.
So, and I suggest we hear it, so we can hear also the lovely filter and the very lightning fast envelopes.
Oh, cool.
So we start out with oscillator A in a square mode. Some noise here, we put this one down. So, this is even without us. If you put out on the resonance, already in the middle it gets like very peak, and that's a nice, so you have a lot of sweet stuff before it goes into full self oscillation. With with the keyboard mount out on self-oscillation, you can also play the filter for bass drum and stuff. So let's hear a bit how what the filter envelope can do for the bass. That's the demonstration. Well,
yeah. So, okay. So, $299 or thereabouts. Hopefully, 2018.
Yes.
Excellent. Exciting. Okay. Yes. Well, thanks very much for showing us that.
Thank you, guys. Nice to meet you and enjoy the show.
Yeah, great. I have to say though, Super Booth is. It's so hot in there. So if you think we're looking a bit sweaty, we're all like in like melting.
We're gonna buy a fan.
You're gonna buy a fan?
Yeah. Right after we leave.
Yeah.
I think Gaz has got a few fans already.
Yes.
Thank you.